the Property Coaching and Wealth Creation Podcast, brought to you by property and business coach Daniel Latto. Join the conversation at www.daniellatto.co.uk. Remember to like and subscribe.
Hi, and welcome to the Property Coaching and Wealth Creation Podcast. My name is Dan Latto, and in this podcast, we've got a Facebook Live. So I did a Facebook Live in the last couple of days, and of course, not everybody can watch the Facebook Lives, but the information in those Facebook Live events are really important. So I wanted to share them, and I wanted to get them down as a podcast. And so here is that Facebook Live. Speak soon.
Morning, everybody. It's Dan Latto speaking. So it's 9:24 here in Spain, or 8:24 in the UK. So I've just got an email from one of my friends who happens to be a client who also happens to train business owners. And he's got some training coming up in the next month or two. So I just wanted to run through what that training was and how it will help other people's businesses. But just before I do that, I actually sent a client on this training, and then she signed up with this person, and they've been a client of theirs for the last 2 years. And I got an email just last week. It was a Facebook Messenger, actually, saying, thank you so much for that introduction. I've been working with them for the last 2 years, and their business is more profitable than it's ever been. So we know that this stuff works. We only recommend stuff that we know works. And so this particular training is going to take place in May. I've got my cheat sheet here, by the way. It's in May the 23rd and July the 24th. So it's 1 day training, and it's specifically aimed at those businesses that are doing more than £100,000 a year in revenue. Because, and I recognize this as well from my own clients, we get people on board, and when we ask them to go through the numbers, and they don't know what we're talking about. But actually quite a lot of business owners are financially illiterate. They don't know that they're broke. They think they're doing really well and they're going out buying new BMW 7 Series or whatever the latest BMW is, spending £500 or £1,000 a month on the latest gadget or gizmo or car or latest phone or a PA because it makes them feel good or whatever, right? And by the way, we've all been there. I know I have too. So this is what people are doing. And then actually, when we get down to the nitty gritty and we start looking at numbers, we're like, hang on a minute, you can't afford all this stuff. You're going to go broke, right? And we can even work out when they're going to go broke, because we can fast forward using forecasting, and we're going to go, oh, you're going to go broke on July the 28th, 2019, because you're going to run out of money then. And so that's what this training is about. But it's not just about turning around that expenditure of cash. It's actually working out about where you can increase your income, your profit. Now, I just want to clarify, there's a difference between income and profit, okay? So I'm sure you've seen this on Apprentice. Who's watched Apprentice? Where we go, I forgot what it is. I forgot what to say, but revenue is about how good you look, but profit is the income is vanity, profit is sanity. Thank you. That's what it was. So profit's what it's all about. I don't care if you're doing £1 million a year, but if you're only earning 50 grand, you've got a problem, right? You've got a big, big problem. It just needs a little shift in your revenues for that 50 grand to disappear, okay? But if you're doing £100,000 a year and you're making 50 grand, brilliant. It's not necessarily easy to double that, but if you did double that, then at least you could also potentially double your profit. But also the other thing is, if you're doing £100,000 a year and you in revenues and you're making £10,000 profit, the easiest way for you to double that profit is not to do £200,000 the next year. It's actually to cut your cost by 10 grand. And it sounds so obvious, right? But that's not what people do, because we're all about growth and expansion and all of that kind of thing. And that's what actually ends up affecting people's businesses and sending them over the edge. Okay, so I've got 7 points here. I can't remember them, so I'll go through them one by one for you. This is what's going to be covered in this one-day event. There's 1 day in May, there's 1 day in July. It's for business owners who are doing 100 grand plus. And if that's not you yet, that's fine. That's something to aim towards. It's just not for you yet. You've got different problems like marketing and sales funnels and closing business and conversion and delivery and all of that stuff. That's a different conversation. You should come on one of my trainings if that's what you want. But for this one, if you're doing more than 100 grand, then this is what you need. So the first one is why financial accounts are the language of business. And more importantly, knowing your numbers, why knowing your numbers will increase your profits and cash. And that's what we were saying earlier. Most people don't know what their numbers are. And not only do they not know what they are today, they cannot forecast them for the following year, the next year, the next year. Well, how can you build and grow expansion? And I know people go, well, you know, I can't just make a guess about where I'm going to be in 3 years. And I get that you can't make a guess, but you can make an educated guess, because then that gives you something to work towards. But you've got to know your numbers. It's the bottom line. By the way, just for clarity on my numbers, I've just done mine, right? Every single day I do my numbers. I see what money's coming. I see what money's gone out, and I update my spreadsheet accordingly. And then I can forecast what we're going to have left at the end of this month. And then we can forecast, because mine's property related mostly, we can forecast what the rents are going to be and so on. So we can do that. But this trading's really for business owners, not property people. Okay, the top three numbers you must understand for an instant financial health check for your company. So that's like getting a snapshot. What are the numbers that you need for a snapshot so that then you can make these instant decisions to go one way or another? If you've got an expenditure decision coming up, you need to know what these numbers are to make a determination as to, are we going to spend that money or not? Are we going to wait till Q4 of next year or not? And if you don't know these numbers, then you're making guesses based on, what? Guesses, right? That's not a way to run a business. Okay, number three, get more money in your bank account in the next 30 days. Well, we like the idea of that, okay? So there are five levers of improving operating cash flow. Most business owners only understand one or two. Get all five and watch your bank account soar. See, it's always about cash flow. It's not about profits necessarily. Profits are good, but how many times have we seen a business that should be profitable on paper and we go to the bank account and they're in overdraft or even worse than that, but taking money from you, the business owner, to keep the business afloat. And I've had times like this in my lettings agency going back 10 years where I'm like, we should be really rich. Where's all the bloody money gone? And it's gone because we don't know where it's gone. Okay, number four, why financial literacy is the number one skill to scale your business while also making it less dependent on you. Now, this is the other part that we see. We see a lot of tired and exhausted business owners that are working 50, 60, 70, 80 hour weeks. And on one hand, that's like a badge of honor, you know, for the Gary Vaynerchuks of this world and for the Grant Cardones and for the Elon Musks who are doing 18 hour days. Good old Elon. And he sleeps under his desk. And then he goes home and realizes his marriage has failed and his kids have disappeared and don't know who he is anymore. So we don't want that for business owners. We want you to be able to take more time off to do the things that you love. And that's what we want for you. So number six is a super simple process to see if you are overpaying tax. Like we've overpaid tax. It's nice when the rebate comes, and this is also due a rebate. When that rebate comes, that's really nice. But how do you know if you're overpaying on your tax? Like, your accountant probably won't tell you, because most accountants are not really accountants. They're more like bookkeepers. I have really good arguments with my accountant. He calls them arguments. I call them discussion points. because I'm really interested in knowing, what do you mean I can't offset that? Why can't I offset that? And what aspect of this can I not do this? And what about this here? And I've read all the books, right? But actually on this one, to be able to just look very quickly and to see if you're overpaying tax, you might even be due a rebate, which if you are, will cover the cost of this training. And then the next one is how to make banks desperate to lend your money. This one's a game changer. Like, all of these are game changers, and it's all going to take place on a one-day event. But it just depends on how much do you want to grow your business. You see, it's about investing money back into not only your business, you know, like better branding, better marketing. We get all of that, more stuff to hand out to people free of charge to drive people back. All that sales funnel stuff's really, really good. But it's also about you being an asset in your business. Because just last week, someone was asking me, so you talked about you investing other assets, Dan. What other assets have you got? So we've got property, we've got business, and we've got stocks and shares, right? They're the three asset classes, right? But actually, there's a fourth, number four, there's a fourth asset class that we find most people are not investing enough in. And that is you. You are your own asset class. And you've got to be investing money in you. Like, to begin with, when you're going from zero to 100 grand, the first thing that you should be investing in, it's not property, it's not stocks and shares, it's not other people's businesses, but it's investing in you, in personal development, in learning how to market, in learning how to close, in learning NLP, and ensuring that your mindset is absolutely in peak performance, so that then you can go and operate at peak performance and close lots of business and grow it to doing more than 100 grand's worth of revenue. And then when you get beyond that, then you can start taking money out once the business is profitable. But this is like a catch 22, because you start doing more than 100 grand, okay, and then you start buying fancy cars and bigger houses and bigger offices and a personal assistant and a VA and all this extra stuff. And by the time you get to £250,000, you're in more debt, your business is in debt, you've got no cash flow, you're having to work 80 hours, and you look back and you go, what the heck happened? How did I get from there to here? And you find yourself in a little bit of bother. So if that is you, or if that's not you, but you want to get more out of your business, take more time off and earn more money, then you need to go and attend this. Now, if you're wondering how to do it, then just drop me a message and I'll put you guys in touch and you can go and have a little chat. I always like to pre-qualify people to make sure that you're a good match for training of this calibre, because not everybody is, you see. And that's okay. That's all right. We're all on different journeys and at different levels of our journey. But we want to make sure that the people attending this are the right people, because then you're going to get the most out of the training. If you're not the right person and you're not quite at the 100 grand mark, you know, if you're close to it, that's fine. But if you're like 25 grand, you're not there yet. That's a training for later on. Don't try and solve a problem that's, you know, 10 steps further down. Solve today's problem, which is marketing, it's sales conversion, it's delivering product to get you to that 100 grand level. All right, if you want any more info, just drop me a message and we'll speak to you on the next video. Take care, guys. Have a great day.
The Property Coaching and Wealth Creation Podcast, brought to you by property and business coach Daniel Latto. Join the conversation at www.daniellatto.co.uk. Remember to like and subscribe.